And thousands of people representing local corporations, families, and schools are expected to walk for a cure next week.
That's right. The JDRF annual walk to cure diabetes is meant to raise both money and awareness for the disease. And joining us now, the co-chairs of the event, Joe and Cheryl Salvain, to tell us a little bit more. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thanks for joining us again. We know this is such a fun event at Churchill Downs. Really doesn't get much better in terms of a backdrop for a good event like this. Tell us what it's all about.
It's about raising money for a cure for juvenile diabetes. The walk is next Saturday, August 24th. Registration's at 11. The walk's at 12:30 at Churchill Downs. So it's a great event.
And you guys have a daughter who has diabetes. She's 28 years old now. Back in 91, you were saying, when she was first diagnosed, very different from now when these kids are diagnosed.
Absolutely. You know, a lot of changes in the technology advances, even simple things. You know, diabetes requires intensive, never-ending management, so you're talking about 5-6 finger sticks a day just to get blood samples to test blood sugar, and multiple insulin injections. You know, back in the 90s, the needles were bigger, so now you have micro-fine needles that enhance quality of life, take some of the edge off those shots. And even the glucose meters were about the size of a brick. Now they're the size of a, you know, a fountain pen, and they take very little blood. So it was very heartbreaking to have to prick a child's finger multiple times to get a sample big enough. Now, it, you know, it's a lot easier. But what we're really looking for is the biological cure for the disease. Back in the 90s, we were, you know, a lot of the lab work was on laboratory mice. Today, we have over 50 human trials, some that are just right in the stage before it goes for FDA approval. And, you know, the most exciting thing for me is within the next 5 years, we hope to have a functional artificial pancreas on the market, which would be a game changer as far as maintaining blood sugar control and eliminating the possibility of complications.
And talk to us about just how prevalent this disease really is.
The prevalence in young adults is increasing over the last 10 years, and every year there are 30,000 new cases in the United States alone. And, you know, there's certainly a human side to that story, and it's very devastating, as we've seen in our personal experience. But even on the, you know, the economic side, it costs the United States about $15 billion a year in medical costs related to the disease.
Even as you just mentioned, there have been great strides in the past 20 or so years. So the money that you raise really does get you guys inches closer to finding a cure. Talk about where the money goes.
A lot of the money, you know, stays in Louisville that's raised locally. There are some exciting research going on at the UofL. But, you know, 80 cents of every dollar goes towards diabetes research. We're, Forbes rates us as one of the top five charities in the U.S. We get an all-star rating from Forbes magazine. So very exciting, though, when you actually see, though, because the JDRF started, you know, in 1970, you know, the parents of children with diabetes, very humble beginnings, and since then they've raised about $1.7 billion for research, and so it's been exciting to be a part of that and see the advances that over the last 20 years.
And we know you guys have a big goal for this year's JDRF walk at Churchill Downs, and Jay Cardosi is going to be there. He's the MC of that event, WLKY, a proud sponsor. It is so much fun. Talk about, you know, what the atmosphere is like at the walk.
It's just, it's a lot of fun. It's the kids all having fun instead of having to prick their finger and worry about blood sugars. It's there's bouncies and a big kids tent and face painting and mascots and food and just fun. I mean, it's just a really fun day for the kids and the families.
So we don't have goats like the fairies, but we do have Churchill Charlie.
Yeah, right. No chickens.
There are some Star Wars characters.
The Star Wars characters.
Yeah. All right, we'll
Absolutely.
Give and take here. All right, guys. Well, still some time to get involved. Thank you all so much for being
Thanks
here.
Thanks for having us.
We're going to get the details up on the screen for you one more time. If you'd like to participate in this year's walk, it will be next Saturday, August 24th. Again, it's at Churchill Downs with registration beginning at 11 a.m. Then the walk starts at 12:30 p.m. For more information, you can visit JDRF.org or you can call 502-485-9397.